Thank you, Mr. Chairman, and thank you all on this esteemed committee. I'm glad to be here. This is my first time speaking on a resolution in front of this committee as a former member. So I appreciate the opportunity to speak on my resolution, H.R. 400. Octavius Valentine Catto was born on February 22, 1839. In his lifetime, he was a leader, social justice advocate, scholar, athlete, educator, orator, military officer, among other things. Mr. Catto gave so much to the city of Philadelphia and to the movement for equality and equity, especially for people of color, despite his life being cut tragically short. He was born a free man. His father, William Catto, had been enslaved and a millwright who earned his freedom, eventually becoming an ordained Presbyterian minister. His mother, Sarah Isabel Kane, was a member of a prominent family in Charleston, South Carolina, where Octavius was born. Mr. Catto moved north with his family when he was a child. He became educated and was the valedictorian of his class at the Institute for Colored Youth in Philadelphia, which would become Cheney. In mid-June 1863, weeks before the Battle of Gettysburg, Pennsylvania Governor Andrew Curtin issued a proclamation urging volunteer enlistment to protect the state from a Confederate invasion. In Philadelphia, Catto raised a company of 90 African-American troops, but those men wouldn't be permitted to join the effort of the other volunteers to defend the state because the commander of the Department of the Susquehanna believed that Congress wouldn't permit men of color to serve limited terms. Catto wasn't deterred. He returned to Philadelphia and supported the enlistment of men of color into the Union Army. He also served with the Pennsylvania National Guard and as a major and inspector for the 5th Brigade of the United States Colored Troops. In 1864, Octavius Catto was one of 155 men of color from the North and South who met in Syracuse, New York, to form the National Equal Rights League, which is considered the first national organization devoted to promoting black equality. Catto was elected secretary of the Pennsylvania State Equal Rights League chapter. The organization rallied for voting suffrage, political causes, streetcar desegregation, and notably advanced and equal education for African-American students from African-American teachers. In January 1865, Mr. Catto delivered the opening address at the celebration of the second anniversary of the Emancipation Proclamation. He led demonstrations that helped push Pennsylvania lawmakers to ratify the 15th Amendment, which, by the way, I have another resolution for in its 150th anniversary this year, and that barred voting discrimination based on race and organized citizens of color and helped bring them to the polls to vote. In 1867, he became captain of the Pythian Baseball Club, an exclusively African-American team, which he organized with a friend who was a fellow graduate of the Institute for Colored Youth. The team was highly successful, declared the best colored team in the city and perhaps in the nation. In the late 1860s, Catto became the highest paid teacher in Philadelphia. In 1869, he was promoted to principal of the Boys Department of the Institute for Colored Youth. This is especially poignant because he was an advocate for the cause of educators of color, educating students of color. On election day, on October 10th, 1871, Mr. Catto was assassinated during election day violence in Philadelphia when rioters opposed to black suffrage attacked him and other black men to prevent them from voting. He was just 32 years old when he was murdered. That is devastating considering all that he could have accomplished in his life had it not been cut short. It is also a marvel that a man could accomplish all that he did in just 32 years. He became a martyr to systemic racism. His profound success and impact in the Philadelphia area and beyond have been commemorated and memorialized by a monument to his heroism outside City Hall in Representative Sims' district. Despite the profound impact of Octavius Valentine Catto's life and work, his prominence and influence have been unduly minimized in our history books. His is a legacy we should all know, and so I've introduced a resolution to honor him. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.